course, you won't see that in Europe, that the leaks are stopped because the police doesn't give permission. I've not seen it in other countries in Asia also, to be honest. So it's a unique Indonesian situation, and I think for the development of football in Indonesia and the possibilities that we have, Indonesia is a fantastic football country, and if we can shorten this out for the long-term future, it will only benefit football and the society. You cannot blame things on the society all the time. So something needs to be addressed, but it's beyond control of us. So I hope that situations like this in the future will not occur anymore. Does it make it easier for football development? The fact that we cannot play in Bandung is of course really disturbing. You have to be honest about it. It is not good for the team, it's not good for the club, it's not good for the supporters. For the team, it's very difficult because you stay not at home, you stay in hotels, and it is very difficult for longer periods because you're playing a league. If it is a tournament, it's a different situation because then all the clubs stay in the same environment. But now, Bandung is forced to play away from home. And then at the moment, we have to stay here because we have to go directly from here to Jakarta. It makes it a very long trip suddenly. And then when you come to Jakarta, the stadium is empty, whereas normally the Boboto should support the team in Jakarta as well. So that makes it for the players also confusing. Why are the Boboto, the real supporters behind Persib Bandung, not allowed to support the team? So it's not easy for any team in the world. If you take any team that have to play outside your own environment for 4 matches, it's not an easy situation. But we have to overcome it. That's our job now. We have to be mentally extremely strong. We have to be positive about everything that we're doing. And we have to fight for the 3 points in every match. Once he is here and once we see the situation tomorrow, then we know how ready he is to enter the squad and maybe also the team again. His attitude is he wants to play, and that is good, that is very positive. And of course we are proud of him. He is the captain of his national team, and the national team in Africa play high quality matches, so it's good to get him back as well.
Ini persiapan terakhir kita. Semua pemain siap untuk bertanding besok. Saya berharap pemain punya motivasi lebih bermain di Bali sini, karena kita punya pengalaman sebelumnya. Saya menginginkan semua pemain fokus untuk 3 poin besok. Insyaallah. Sebagai tim yang solid, tim yang kuat, mereka punya pemain yang berkualitas, tetapi yang terpenting bagaimana kita tidak memikirkan tim lain, pikirkan fokus ke tim kita, bagaimana kita bermain besok.